congratulations and very special thanks to the Atlanta Committee for the Olympic Games.
A hot August night in Centennial Olympic Park. As the games close, the people of Atlanta pass the baton to the next hopeful city.
I call upon the youth of the world to assemble 4 years from now at Sydney, Australia, to celebrate with us the games of the 27th Olympiad, the first games of the new millennium.
This is the tale of two mayors and a flag which will envelop their cities and their lives.
Now the exchange from Mayor Bill Campbell of Atlanta to Juan Antonio Samaranch, who then will pass the Olympic flag to the mayor of Sydney, Australia, Frank Sarter. Sarter, a father of two, he's 44 years of age, first elected in 91, re-elected in 95, needs a third term to be there in 2000.
Days before the opening ceremony, and time has run out for Atlanta.
We're waiting for the mayor to come to the curb. Where? He's coming behind.
Okay, the mayor's coming to the curb.
The Olympic Circus is about to arrive, and it will change this city forever.
Oh, you're riding the tour path. The mayor's going to be right here. So the car's going to pull up this way. So we just need to move the flags to the other side.
I know where they're at.
The bus is going to clear color line.
Atlanta Mayor Bill Campbell faces his ultimate test of fire. Nothing he's done before could prepare him for the events of the next fortnight. Even now, critics say his city is not ready for the coming onslaught. Today, Bill Campbell is hosting a reception for the most important people in town.
Hello, George. So nice to see you. My pleasure. Thank you for the support.
Sponsors and the all-powerful International Olympic Committee. These are the people who gave Atlanta the Games and its moment in history.
Welcome to Atlanta. Welcome to Atlanta.
In the next fortnight, they will pass judgment on Atlanta's performance.
At last, this moment has arrived for our great city. For 6 long years, Atlanta has prepared to welcome the world. We've worked hard to meet this challenge. We've reached down into our roots, and we give you our unique Southern culture, much like the Olympic movement itself, comprised of many cultures and voices.
With the latest news from the CNN Airport Network, I'm Valerie Hoff.
Atlanta is expecting 2 million Olympic visitors.
You want us to move?
Among them, Sydney's Lord Mayor, Frank Sarter. Vice President of the Sydney Organising Committee, Frank is here to collect the flag for Sydney, but especially to learn from Atlanta's experience.
What's your name?
Jan.
Jan, Frank. I'm going to shake hands.
Oh, thank you.
How do you do?
Welcome to Atlanta.
Now, on the way out, are we going out the normal way or are we going the special way?
No, we're going the normal way.
Just point out any Olympic signs. I just want to watch everything. I'm here to absorb. I'm here to be a sponge.
The general manager of the Sydney Council, Greg Maddock, is also travelling with the mayor.
So what's the highest in the last week been?
Oh, golly, 95.
95 degrees.
And very high humidity.
And what's the forecast for the games?
Also in the party are Frank's wife, Judy Fleming, and Press Secretary Beth Powell.
There he is, in a big neon sign.
Yeah,
we'll have to get some of those.
Mayor Bill Campbell, welcome to you. When I came in from Barcelona Airport, along the roadway, every 100 metres there was a man with a submachine gun.
There's your city of Atlanta.
Mayor Bill Campbell has held the job for just 2 years. Now he has been propelled to a fortnight of stardom. Occasions like this can cement his political future.
The reviews that we've been getting from the people all around the world that have been visiting our city over the last week seems to be uniformly positive. I think the airport, which of course is where most of the people will be arriving.
Mayor Campbell is doing a live interview at this time with WGST Radio, which is the official Olympic information station in Atlanta. He's talking about the city's preparedness for the games and the IOC reception, which he's hosting tonight.
We have met with a number of both church and business leaders.
Frank Sarto's time is yet to come. The son of Italian migrants, fame and responsibility will be thrust upon him in a fortnight when he accepts the Olympic flag for Sydney.
You know, the seats in the stadium were built by Australians, installed by Australians.
Atlanta's symbol is the Phoenix, a city risen from the ashes of the Civil War. The city of Gone with the Wind is a city of vast new wealth, but lingering black poverty. Now, Atlanta must put on its best face to the world. The poorest neighbourhoods have been spruced up, especially those in the shadow of the new stadium.
Great opportunity for our community. This is sensational, okay, isn't it? Okay. And thank you, wonderful people.
Miss Alberta Mitchell's house in Summerhill has become the climax of Operation Clean Brush.
Welcome to my house.
And it looks fantastic. And being one of the neighbors in these areas, I think it's beautiful. And Miss Mitchell thinks her house looks fantastic, and so do I. Look at it, she even put her flowers out. We just wish that we could have the Olympics every year, and then that way we know this place would be beautiful after 2 or 3 years.
What used to be next door here?
That was a big old vacant house with lots of people tramping in and staying at night and doing everything. So they finally tore it down. I was glad of it because it made a flexion on this house, you know.
When did they take it down?
About 3 weeks ago.
Oh, nice to see
nice
you.
To meet
my
you.
Pleasure. How
my
you doing?
My son Adam and my daughter.
Yeah, ma'am. Nice
this
to see all of you.
Secretary Pauline Helen.
Good to see you. Hello,
and this
lady.
This is Amber, my daughter's friend.
Hello, Amber. How you doing, bud?
All right. You need to start.
Mayor Campbell has sponsored the neighborhood cleanup, along with unions and private industry.
Sherwin Williams, Vice President.
Thank you very, very much. It wouldn't have been possible without your very generous donation.
Our pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Well, it's a great time for Atlanta.
It sure is.
And your philanthropy has really made a difference.
It's going to be a busy time for you.
It is a busy time. It is a busy time. Well, come on up. We'll go and get this thing started.
Today, the mayor can bask in his civic largesse.
Good morning to everybody.
You move up to the microphone here so they can hear you.
Good morning to everybody. You all are welcome to my house. You know, I've been living here for 33 years, and I'm so happy to know that my house is painted and looking good. And I thank all y'all. I thank the mayor, and I thank the painters again. They are very good people. So I'm so thankful. I thank the mayor for coming out today, and I thank all these friends for being so nice to me. I'm glad to know that somebody cares. So I believe y'all cares for me and make me live longer. All these years I done lived, now I'm happy than I ever been in my life on Fraser Street. And I hope everybody in the neighborhood is happy.
First, let's check Atlanta's most accurate, dependable weather forecast. Here's WSB meteorologist Kirk Mellish.
Scott, today right through Friday, partly sunny, hot and humid, highs 91 to 94 and lows 71 to 75.
With the city's new paint barely dry, it's now the day before the opening ceremony of the Games. The IOC Hotel, Atlanta's Marriott Marquis, disgorges its very important guests, the inner circle of the Olympic family. Frank Sartor's morning newspaper carries the story of a TWA air disaster off New York. Talk of terrorism has raised the temperature in Atlanta.
I'm off to CBS for the Today Show in Sydney.
All right.
Yeah, what am I here for, Beth?
Well, we're looking at cultural venues. We're looking at...
No, we're looking at... Write the things down. Yeah. We're looking at... We've got, I'm here for
cultural
the flag
program.
Ceremony.
No,
here for the flag
yeah,
ceremony.
Yeah, bring the flag home.
Flag.
We're looking at city dressings.
Yeah, city, just city management.
Just here, we come to here all the time. We come to.
We've got impatience flying everywhere.
Impatience, I am too.
Yep.
Now, I'm talking to Liz and Steve, is that right?
Correct. It'll be just one or the other. I'm not sure who it is at this point in time.
Mr. Sartor, good morning.
Good morning, Liz. How are you?
I'm very well. I guess we all know that one of the most important factors and in planning for and indeed conducting the Olympics is security. I mean, this sort of tragedy with TWA heightened your awareness as the host of the next Olympics?
Yeah, it certainly does. But and I'm told that they've stepped up security by about 50%. Just in case there was something untoward with the air crash.
Good morning to you. Look for some partly cloudy skies today. Patchy morning fog, a chance of afternoon thunderstorms at a high in the lower 90s. Right now, 75 degrees. We're going to check traffic and then to the phones with your calls for the mayor in just a couple of moments. Good morning, CC McGee.
Good morning.
Good morning.
All right,
hey.
How are you doing?
How are you doing?
There you go.
Good to see
Raleigh,
you. You've done a good job.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mr. Campbell, Mr. Mayor, I gotta tell you, the city looks fantastic.
It
does.
Doesn't it look great? And people really appreciate it, not only the people who are visiting, but the people who live here. I mean, everybody is positive about it. All the visitors are giving us high marks. They're enjoying the city.
What are the things you're looking out for on this trip?
In general terms, how smoothly the whole operation runs, what sort of hitches there are. But one of the things that's come through to me already is I think that Atlanta, again, is scoring very close to 10 out of 10 on the question of friendliness and hospitality.
Are we going to be able to keep this up after the games? I mean, that's
the reason I think people are so excited who live here is because they see all this great stuff that we've done to get the city ready for the games that will have a lasting legacy. Doesn't mean that we've made everybody happy.
Right.
That's impossible to do.
You know,
Mike, if you all give away free money, some people don't want that.
Yeah.
And so you know that it's hard to find a way to make everybody happy.
Later, Frank Sartor is invited to speak at a business lunch in the suburbs, the Kiwanis Club.
Fellow Kiwanians, let's join John and Frank in singing God Bless America.